value-added approach is also known as the production approach and measures GDP from the supply side of the market. It adds up all the final output of goods and services, then subtracts the total of intermediate goods. The categories of goods produced and measured in this approach are durable goods, non-durable goods, services, structures, and changes in inventory. Durable goods are long-lasting products such as vehicles and appliances. Non-durable goods, in contrast, are products that have a short lifespan, such as food, clothes, and consumer goods such as toothpaste and laundry detergent. When economists use the value-added approach, they estimate the gross value of domestic output by adding the value of all goods and services produced within the country's borders, whether the goods or services are intermediate or not. Then, the cost of the intermediate goods used to produce the final goods and services are deducted from the final value to obtain the net value of domestic output. Using the value-added approach to measure the contribution that an automobile produced in the United States makes to GDP, first, sum the cost of each intermediate step in the production process. For instance, add the cost of the tires and the battery produced and delivered by outside suppliers to the overall value of the car as it's assembled. Once the manufacturing process is complete, subtract the value added at each intermediate step from the final retail sales price of the car. Subtracting the value added at each step of the manufacturing process avoids double counting and overstating the car's contribution to GDP. Calculating GDP using the value-added approach requires the careful tracking of supply chains and manufacturing processes to ensure that goods and services in the economy are not accounted for twice.